Akilan, the general manager NLS for Naizak. So my first question to you is, could you tell me something about the products that you are displaying at ArabLAB, you know, and some of the specific features of the products that helps you stand apart from your other companies and competitors, you know, peers?
Our division covers a complete solution for a wide spectrum of laboratories, starting from environmental to oil and gas sector to petrochemical industry, research and development, and academia. Those are our major areas now. In addition, now we are going into areas like food safety, water analysis, and that is on the public health sector. We are also involved with the regulatory agencies in the region, like SFDA in Saudi Arabia, forensic labs, doping, anti-doping for human and animal, where it's becoming now a big issue, international and regional. We see that most of our customers in our marketplace here are looking for solutions. So they are interested into areas where they can start from sample preparation, development of the capability of the laboratory technicians to know better on how to use the advanced technology and how to produce accurate results on their analysis, where quality counts most. Now, the ArabLAB in general, where we started as in our division as 6 years ago, we started in a booth, then we grew up to be, I believe, the largest, as we cover a full spectrum of laboratory solutions from analytical instrumentation to the area of automation. Then we go into the LIMS, which is a laboratory information management software system covering the entire spectrum of laboratory, from health sector to public health to petrochemical, oil and gas industry, as well as academia and research area.
Sir, in terms of the sectors, like you mentioned, which is the sector which is growing and is going to come to grow in the next 3-4 years? You know, why has it become so important for this sector to grow suddenly?
We strongly look at the regulated area, as it wasn't in the past until recent, the last 2-3 years, coming up with the regulatory agencies of the region in GCC countries, putting it, implementing it, and enforcing it. This is the most crucial part for public health sector. Now, of course, the region is oil and gas industry as well as petrochemical industry, and that sector is always growing because it is tangible for the economy of the area. However, we look at the sector of municipality and the public health sector as a very important and growing sector as well. And we see customers coming from the entire Middle East region, mainly, of course, out of GCC countries, end users, project managers, heads of laboratory, all the concerned into the lab marketplace are considering now the ArabLAB to be the focal point of the annual meeting for them. This is what you see here is the show case of the ArabLAB, but parallel to it, there is a scientific session going on with seminars and papers and what have you. To us, we believe it is an investment worth every real we put in it. Okay.
Sir, in terms of some of the trends, you know, what are the trends that are dominant and something that has really picked up and, you know, customers are asking for it? What is some of those trends?
It's always about advanced technologies. That's what people are looking for, because the day-to-day is already well covered. So everyone is coming in and asking for what do you have as the most advanced to analyze the following chemistry or to analyze the following material testing. So people are no longer talking about the everyday product. They are all interested because they got more and more professional and well educated. And so they now, with the website and the revolution of the internet and as an information source. They all come visiting and looking for what do you have new as an advanced technology.
Sir, I want to ask from you, you know, since as industry leaders and since you've been leading the industry and playing such an important role as a technology solutions provider, could you give me a sense of the issues, you know, you face in terms of there is a lot of potential in Middle East, but we are not able to capture the potential. What are some of the issues that is holding back companies, you know?
I would capitalize on the end user training and the laboratory technologist training. As the technology now is far more advanced than a laboratory technician trained only on the basic will not get the best product and result out of an advanced technology instrument. So I see the area with the great emphasis on training and training and training to develop the technology and the capability of using the technology.
So could you give me a sense of, it seems to be buzzing today, you know, it has really crowded, people are pouring in and speaking about solutions and all. Could you give me a sense of the kind of visitors that have come, you know, what are the inquiries, what are customers asking for?
As we cover a very wide portfolio of products, we see customers from all sectors of the marketplace. And you go from the simple UV visible type instrumentation for the day-to-day to electron microscopy. We have our partners showing as well in the nanotechnology and the software controlling the laboratory technology results as well. Part of that is the one you see behind me here, where we call it LIMS, Laboratory Information Management Systems.
And thank you so much, sir. The interview was really insightful. You know, the talk was insightful. And our users will definitely benefit from it. And I wish you all the success for the remaining days of the exhibition.
Certainly. Thank you.
Thank you so much.